Raider Nation. What's going on? You're watching the Raiders Report, brought to you by BetDSI, and I'm your host, Mitchell Rance. I got a six-pack of Raiders rumors on tap for y'all, so you ready to kick this one started? I know I am. The first rumor I got coming up here, it's around a wide receiver, and it's Brandon LaFell, and if he's going to be out the entire season, this one's for Chucky Heads. Believe it, baby. He left week 11 with an injury, and at the time, we didn't really know what that injury was. This was after Brandon LaFell had a receiving touchdown, which you can see down there, two catches, 29 yards, and a touchdown. And personally, I thought he looked pretty good, and it was a reliable option for Derek Carr. But unfortunately, his season will end because he has a ruptured Achilles. For a player like LaFell, who's bounced around the NFL, these are his career stats. In 125 games, 5,398 yards, 31 touchdowns. He's been productive on multiple teams. Now, he's never had a 1,000-yard season. His best season came in 2014 when he was with the New England Patriots, when he had 74 receptions, 956 yards, and 7 touchdowns. The bad news is, though, for a player like Brandon LaFell, with an injury like this, with a wide receiver who's over 30 years old, this probably is going to lead to the end of his career. So, Brandon, even though you were only with us for a short time, man, best of luck to you. Shout out to you. Once a Raider, always a Raider. Raider Nation, hey, if you like what I'm doing here at Chat Sports, this is what you're going to have to do. You're going to go down there at that link. See it? You're going to subscribe, youtube.com/Raiders Report, because I'm going to be releasing a whole bunch of new Raiders content. And hey, if you want to join the show, I got a Raider Nation Rumors fun little segment, which you can only watch and be a part of if you subscribe below, youtube.com/Raiders Report. If you're new to the show, you're going to need to understand my Raider Rumor Scale. Zero Chucky Heads, tuck rule, tuck that. This rumor, not going to happen. One Chucky Head is a small shred of the truth. I like to think 25% chance of happening. Two Chucky Heads, people are talking, 50-50. Three Chucky Heads, pretty likely, 75% chance of happening. And then four Chucky Heads, believe it, baby, 100% this rumor is going to happen. Now I'm going to hop into my second rumor, and it's around another wide receiver. It's Keon Hatcher, and have the Raiders resigned him. This one's four Chucky Heads, believe it, baby. Now, it's interesting with Hatcher because, I don't know if you remember, but they kept Hatcher over Martavis Bryant after the preseason because Hatcher was just the more reliable option. They were a little bit unsure what was going on with Martavis Bryant, but after his season opener, he was waived. The Raiders said, all right, well, we're going to let him go, and then, as you know, Martavis Bryant ended up coming back a few weeks later. Now, what I want you to think about with Hatcher is he had a great preseason. And in that final preseason game, sure, it's the fourth one, and it's, you know, where most of the starters don't play, but eight catches for 128 yards and three touchdowns. He showed that he could be a big-bodied, reliable receiver in the red zone. So if he can maybe bring a little bit of that to a really, really banged-up depth chart, as you can see here, like, that's all we're looking for. Seth Roberts right now is the wide receiver one, and then Marcel Aitman there at number two. You could probably switch those guys back and forth. Heck, when Dwayne Harris went down with an injury, that was really, you know, scary because he's also our punt returner. So the fact that this receiving depth chart is getting so thin, and just adding another player like Hatcher, who's another body, is something that I think we can all agree we need. So with the low depth chart and wide receiver talent, could you play wide receiver for the Raiders? Now I want to have a little bit of fun for this one. So type one for yes or type two for no. Heck, just tell me if you've ever played football. Me personally, I never played football. So I'll be honest, I probably couldn't play wide receiver for the Raiders. The next rumor I got coming up here, it's around Daniel Carlson. And do I trust him? I'm going to give this one three Chucky Heads. Pretty likely that I trust him. And I think that you should too. So here's the thing with him. It wasn't the first time that Daniel Carlson lined up to attempt a game-winning field goal. But this time, it was a little bit of a different result. In week two against the Green Bay Packers, Carlson, a member of the Vikings at the time, was thrust into late into the game. But he ended up missing the field goal. And ultimately, the Vikings tied the Packers. Well, guess what happened? Shortly after that, the Vikings said, all right, man, deuces, you're out. They waived him in week two. But this is what I want you to remember. If you want a good little Google search, go Google Daniel Carlson because he is the all-time leader in the SEC in points scored. He has had an unbelievable career in college, and he had one bad game. I think we've all had a bad day at work or a bad game growing up. He's had one bad game, and they ended up getting waived, and he's been pretty productive and been pretty reliable for the Raiders. So all I'm saying is this is a big clutch kick for a young 23-year-old, and if the Raiders can just rely on him and if he can get his confidence and swagger back, he could be a pretty good kicker for a long, long time. So the fact that the Raiders won, okay, this is the other side of the bullet. Are you happy that the Raiders won the game? We know that this is a lost season. They're 2-8 and ultimately not going to make the playoffs. We know that. So, with 2019 in mind, are you happy that the Raiders won the game? I want you to type a Y for yes or type N for no. I'm always happy when the Raiders win because, hey, it makes my show a little bit more fun. But in terms of 2019, am I happy? No. Obviously, the pick changes a little bit. I want to give a shout-out to Mizzen+Main for making me look pretty decent today. And if you guys want to go to Mizzen+Main and wear these comfortable shirts, you're going to go to comfortable.af. Why is it .af? I get asked that all the time. It's because these shirts are indeed comfortable as F. I promise you, you will not find a better dress shirt on the internet. Heck, you're not going to find a better dress shirt anywhere. Shout out to Mizzen+Main for making me look pretty solid. All right, next rumor coming up here on the board. Week 11 was bad for the Raiders. I'm giving this one 4 Chucky heads, and I'm saying believe it, baby. The Raiders, the Cowboys, and the Bears all won. Why is that bad? Well, the Raiders have the first pick, or were going to have the first pick, which is now the third pick because they ended up winning. When they traded with Amari Cooper from the Cowboys, well, that pick is already now up to 17. And then the fact that the Bears won their other first-round pick, now that's at pick 26. So last week, the Raiders would have had the first overall pick, and now they don't have it anymore. So, Raider Nation, I want to know from you. The Raiders' first pick in the NFL draft will be ... I would have said pick number one. Heck, I said they were going to have the first overall pick on Thursday's Raiders report. Now they have the third pick in the 2019 NFL draft, but I want to know from you. Their first pick in the 2019 NFL draft will be, hey, just comment below. Next rumor, this one is going to get a little violent. Well, maybe. It's around Lee Smith, and did he grab Jon Gruden's neck? I'm going to give this one 2 Chucky heads because people are talking. So there was a report that came out that Smith grabbed Gruden by the neck. The reason why this is only 2 Chucky heads is because from what I'm reading or from what I'm gathering, when I think of grabbing somebody by the neck, I think of this, right? I think of literally just choke slamming somebody, grabbing him by the throat. Well, apparently Lee was trying to just pull Gruden away from Derek Carr because they got into a little bit of a scuffle, which, hey, you may actually be hearing about in a little bit. But it sounds like he was just kind of like tugging on him a little bit. So when I hear that, I don't really think of him grabbing by the neck. Now, Lee did come out and say that he probably shouldn't have grabbed the head coach. And I agree. You shouldn't grab the head coach. I totally understand that. But at the end of the day, these are full-grown men. And when you get upset, sometimes your emotions happen. And honestly, I like the fact that they got upset because, hey, that to me, that means that they still care. You know what I care about? Winning money. And I love winning money. And I bet on the Raiders yesterday. And guess what? Your boy, he wants some money. If you guys want to bet on Raiders games or, heck, any NFL game the entire season, there's only one place to do it, and that's at BetDSI, the number one sports book on the internet. You're going to go to chatsports.com/bet. You're going to use our nice little promo code up there, Live120, for 120% deposit bonus. Mitch, what the hell does that mean? It means if you put down $50, you get $60 for free. Heck, you put down $100, guess what? You're going to get $120 for free. Shout out to BetDSI for hooking us up with that promo. The last rumor I got in my six-pack that I'm ready to chug, it's did Derek Carr and Jon Gruden get into a fight? I'm going to give this one 1 Chucky head, and I think there's a small shred of truth. Now, there was a disagreement. If you were watching the game, the play was 3rd and 5, and Derek Carr threw the ball deep to Jalen Richard down the right sideline. And Jon Gruden was pissed. Like, straight up, he was mad that Derek Carr made that play on 3rd and 5 to a halfback who was pretty well covered. And the fact that Jon Gruden and then Derek Carr got into a little bit of a, we'll say, an arguing match, I'm not really going to consider that a fight. Now, there was multiple reporters that were saying, hey, Gruden, Carr, they're having a fight. And Gruden said, yeah, we had a mild disagreement. Everything's good. If you can't get mad at the people that you work with, I'm sorry you don't love them. If you never got mad at your wife, your girlfriend, heck, whoever, that means you do not care about them. The fact that Gruden got mad at Carr, I like it. And honestly, let's also tip our cap to Derek. Sure, he didn't light up the scoreboard in yards, but 2 touchdowns, 0 interceptions. It was pretty productive for the Raiders, and he actually hasn't thrown an interception in the past 5 weeks. So, Derek, hey, y'all wanted him to take care of the ball? Guess what? He's finally doing it, and I think John is starting to notice that too. Raider Nation, what's going on? You're watching the Raiders Report brought to you by BetDSI, and I'm your host, Mitchell Renz. And if you liked what you heard today, follow me on Twitter, at MitchellRenz365, and remember to subscribe to that nice little link below, youtube.com/Raiders Report. I'll be back later on in the week with some more Raiders rumors. So until then, go Raiders.